afternoon, mates. It's Paul, your semi-professional YouTube host and always manservant. How are you? We're 12 days into the new year, and I see that things are about the same from a rhetoric standpoint with the twittering Donald Trump and the shithole countries that we're trying to keep out of, it's people out of our country because they're just obviously not good enough. What is this man thinking? I mean, yes, we know he's always had an ego, but I'm kind of really surprised that so often that he can go on and on changing his stories about things. Even from one day to the next, he said it or he didn't say it. Well, you know that you might as well put both editions in the next false newspaper or television report you see or read, because he's going to say that he never said that, and they misinterpreted, and they're only giving you false news again. I don't know. I just, you know, if it wasn't so serious for all of us here in the U.S. of A., I definitely would be start to put bottled water collected in, well, if I had a basement, I put it in a basement along with a 6-month supply of ready-to-eat army rations and maybe a self-composting toilet, so that at least when the fallout is back to a level of safety again, that I could go out and plant some of Michigan gardener Luke's seeds in my wonderful composted yard. It's got a lot of ash in it, but I can mix that in after the radiation is down to a low enough level, and we'll get some nice carrots out of the deal. Wow, I just I put in Twitter yesterday, please give me at least a 24-hour period when I don't have to hear the name of Trump and what he just said in Twitter. And while we're at it, give me another one of those days. I'll take 24 hours of that day and hope that I don't have to read about anybody whose seamy side of power went awry and he basically started to act inappropriately. Well, let's make it fair. He or she started to act inappropriately with him or her or them. Just, we're really coming apart at the wheels on our trolley bus, and I don't know, you know, what all this leads to. I mean, you have to be a hell of an optimist or incredibly out of it to not feel just a little bit dragged down by it all. You know, in the light of the fact of all the people who, those very, very nice people and the white supremacy team that ran into a few people in Charlottesville, Virginia this past few months, I wonder how that's going to coordinate with the president's glowing assessment of how wonderful the celebration of that icon of liberty, Martin Luther King Day, is going to be January 15th. I just don't see how he'll be able to erase all the things that he's concocted and that actual black people would be able to say, wow, this guy's amazing. We've got freedom. We have better than we ever had with Prez Obama and his lovely wife, Michelle. I just don't know how that's going to play, whether it be Newark, New Jersey, or Watts, L.A., or south side of San Francisco. Yeah, go, O.J. Run, O.J. Run, O.J. Yeah, I feel like running with O.J., probably to Canada. I love my Canada, but that's a story for another day. No, I still feel good about the new year. Brad and I have discussed a lot of things. We've had plenty of time over these last few weeks to just talk about you know, where we are now and what we've seen all these years. And I will tell you guys that I love this YouTube venue, and living happily gay is, well, it's not just a metaphor, it really is true. I have cast aside any of the last remaining shreds of insecurity of my early adult life and late teen life, where I was so afraid that I couldn't be like everyone else. Boy, what a waste of time that was. I think I'd like to have those 20 years back. Of course, things were different then, when people, you know, oftentimes dissed the gay people as being just the scourge of America. Well, we know better than that now. There would be no Dancing with the Stars without our wonderful staff of designers that ABC has been able to concoct and gather together at high pay to, you know, make a show that glues America when it's on. So yeah, I have been discussing with Brad, and he's been discussing with me, you know, how we all feel like we fit into this arrangement of life. And I think that we feel a little smug, but in a good way, that we've cast aside the last vestiges of our insecurity about being different from some other people. Well, hell, there's certainly enough icons that have come out, and that they certainly haven't been destroyed. Their careers are still flowing rather well, like Jim Parsons and Ellen DeGeneres. And Ellen, I'm sorry that your dad passed away. He was a good man. I know he had a good sense of humor, and you had inherited that. And of course, he was a New Orleanian, which you were too, and I know that's where your special insight and humanity comes from. We love you, Ellen. Really love you. But you know, there's a lot of baggage that over the years it just had to be expelled and just spit up and pooped out and all that kind of stuff that really is unpleasant. But you know what? You really start to learn that it is your little puzzle piece, and it's a very little puzzle piece that fits into this whole schema of the three-dimensional world and how we all fit into it. And of course, Donald Trump's got a couple of big chunks. That's why the world knows what he's saying. Unfortunately for him, it's not for a good reason, but oh, except in Wall Street, they dig him, because he is bringing hope back to the people that lost it. Unfortunately, they're not the people that I'd love to see empowered in this country, because they're certainly a very non-progressive group of people. They loved the status quo in the 60s and 70s, and when they lost it in the 80s, and they've been bitching about it from the 90s to the new century, that makes it all a little bit different. But I just wanted to say to you all, as we are coming up on 600,000, yes, that's right, 600,000 views of Living Happily Gay, probably in the next week or two, unless you guys really want to do us a big favor and just click it on in and start dipping into those articles that are in video format. And I guess there's 55 of them, including this one, that give you anything you ever want to know about most things. Because this is a fun channel. This is a learning channel. This is a feel proud channel. This is a fuck you channel. But it is very, very important that you know that you're a great person. And I do this, and Brad does this for, you know, for you. I mean, I'm not going to lie to you. There are days that I said, I just can't get myself motivated enough to start spewing stuff on video. But you know what? These things have to be said. We don't talk about it. This doesn't dominate our day. But we need to have this. This should be recorded, because it's so unique. We're living through a history lesson right now. Unfortunately, the final chapter of that history lesson won't be told until somewhere, I hope, past 5 to 10 years. I think we could get that out, but I don't really know. I mean, it's definitely backlashed to the point that we're we're dealing with situations that are a little bit scary, and Rocketman doesn't like it either. So I just don't know where we're going with the world. But you're improving yourself. You're getting stronger. You're getting more proud of yourself. You're being empowered. You are equal, if not better, than your straight neighbor next door, because you have had a little bit more of a struggle. But you know what? You proved yourself, and you are a good human being. And you are very viable on our earth, certainly, and we're very welcome, because we make life better for a lot of people. You know, I don't always feel great about knowing that, and some of my older friends, my middle-aged friends that are dabbling with YouTube, that are getting straight, and they kind of say, gee, we see that you're doing so well with your channel. And I say, well, I just don't, I must be looking at different numbers, because I don't see it that way. Well, I guess when you're looking at 50 subscribers versus, you know, whatever the hell we are, 17,000, something like that, getting there. A little over, I guess. But, yeah, it's, and thank you. I always say that there is no living happily gay without your pushing that button to say subscribe. And pushing the like and pushing the share and the thumbs up, some thumbs down, but way more. And I think that's what we can both say. But you know, the miracle might not happen economically to us guys that are grandfathered into this environment, because maybe it's not meant to be. Maybe it you know, we don't necessarily have 20 years to develop a following. We didn't start with the when YouTube was first born, and you were just fooling around, and you know, you picked up people here and there, and they were just fooling around, and so that was your core audience. And it's nothing like starting out in 2006 when everything was fresh and you could take chances and you could develop a program that became part of people's lives a lot more readily than when there's 3 or 4 or 5 whatever million channels out there. But so we might not economically benefit, but boy, does this help reaching out to like-minded people and saying, hey, I like myself. I like you. I'm proud of you and you and you. I'm happy and I am living gay. And that's where the title came from. This channel is Living Happily Gay, but it's living happily just being. And that's what you all want. That's what we all want. That we want some sense of comfort. We want a sense of purpose. We want to feel like we've succeeded in something. And monetarily is only one measurement. So when you look at PewDiePie's numbers, and I just use him as one example because it's so fantastically large, but you know, he puts a good product out there. But he's got the age. He's got the acumen of knowing how to deal with the gamesmanship that people so crave. And so many like him. It helps to be under 35. It really does. And I know that. But you know what? I'm 20 inside. And in all fairness, I do look pretty damn good too, even as I approach middle age, or now I'm in middle age. It's really, as they say, it's just a number. But we love you. Brad and I really have developed a taste for communicating with you, and we want that to go on for a long time. Money notwithstanding, that's not going to change anything. Maybe make us a little more enthusiastic when maybe we don't want to do a show, but we're here for you. Thank you, guys. Thank you, YouTube. Thank you for subscribing to Living Happily Gay, and take care of yourself. Ball signing off. Bye.